Dominating the coastal forests from Washington to Southeast Alaska, the red cedar has been the tree of life for the native peoples of the region for thousands of years. Its inner bark provided fiber for baskets, mats, rope, and clothing. Dugout canoes up to 60 feet long were fashioned from the trunks, and large communal houses were built with massive cedar posts, beams, and planks. Straight-grained, easily carved, and highly resistant to rot, red cedar is an ideal material for the monumental sculptures that we know as totem poles. In 1968, oil was discovered at Prudhoe Bay in northern Alaska. The 1977 completion of the Trans-Alaska Pipeline led to an oil boom. Royalty revenues from oil have funded large state budgets from 1980 onward. That same year, not coincidentally, Alaska repealed its state income tax. In 1989, the Exxon Valdez, an oil tanker belonging to the crude oil company ExxonMobil, hit a reef in the waters close to the coastal city of Valdez, not far from Anchorage. The oil spread over 1,300 miles of coastline, and a huge part of the ocean had a layer of oil on it. Uncountable number of fish, sea otters, seals, orca, birds died. For months, people battled to wash off the oil from the coast with jets of hot water. Planes sprayed chemicals that would mix the oil with the water. Part of the oil on the ocean surface was burnt. The litigation against ExxonMobil lasted almost 20 years. Then, in 2010, another oil spill exceeded the Exxon Valdez disaster. An oil well in the ocean floor, operated by British Petroleum in the Gulf of Mexico, exploded. A combination of several methods were used to combat the spill, including one where genetically engineered microbes were introduced that ate methane. Disasters of such magnitude have long-term effects on the population of marine species and travel up the food chain as mammals and birds eat the contaminated fish.